The next step that I'll take a look at, I really don't want to call them necessarily a machining step because there's not a lot of machining as referring to the milling machine or to the lathe. But the two pieces that I'll still need to make to connect the valve that was in this portion of the cylinder head to the eccentric hub that we built in the last video requires actually two pieces. You've got item number 13, which is the brass sleeve that you saw a while ago, and also it is this eccentric rod. Actually, the only work that needs to be done to this right here is putting a 3/48 thread on both ends, and I'll come back about 3/8 of an inch to do that. Now, this will likely have to be bent a little bit. Mostly the way it's bent, and I'll exaggerate this, it comes out and then it goes over to an angle and then up to the valve. So it has a little step bend in it. And that's what I call the fiddling and the fussing stage of this. And you'll just have to do that. And it's not the primary way that you adjust the travel back and forth. It just sets the valve. Of course, the valve is up here on this end that slides back and forth. And the eccentric hub is back here. So the pieces that I'll be making this time, and they're just straightforward, is the part here and the rod. The eccentric itself, remember we had the eccentric hub, this is the eccentric, and the only thing that is here is I'll just drill through with a 46 drill and then tap it for a 3/48 thread, and also I'll take it to the milling machine and I'll mill a very slight flat across the top of that, just a very, very slight flat, because I want a nut to go up against there. So I won't show you that. I'll just show that whenever I get back from the operation. I changed my mind. I think I will show you how an alternate way to do the filing, putting the flat on that eccentric. And this is a trick that I had learned a little while back. Instead of spending the time putting this in a milling machine and cinching everything down and doing a precision measurement, remember, the only thing I need to do here is just have a flat spot for a 3/48 nut. I'll show you an easy way to do that. Now, I've got my machinist vise right here. Now, this is not hardened steel, but it's pretty hard steel. And I have just got the smallest part of that ring sticking up over that. In other words, it just barely catches it. It will catch it if with a pencil, but it'll also go over it. It's just above a slight bump, or just above the surface area, a very slight bump. It probably doesn't even show in the videos. I take the file like this, and this is going to keep everything, and all I have to do is just file that off, and the vise itself will become the guide. And when I get down to where I am filing across the vise itself, just like that, file in a couple different directions to make sure. And now I have milled that down just as if I would have had it in a milling machine. Now the next thing to do is take it out. I put a little bit of dichem dye on it. Take the dichem dye out. And then I'll just split the difference between those two sides and drill my hole. So that's a little tip when you don't want to set your milling machine up for a non-critical, yet you do want a good appearance for the nut to fasten down tightly on. Next thing is, this is 250 thousandths wide. I want to go halfway between it. Obviously that's 125 thousandths. Come back 125 thousandths, tighten that up, run it across. And right there, you won't be able to see that line on the video perhaps, but right there is the center. So now all I need to do, put it back in this vise. I want to line it up to get my flat as close as possible to the top. Now the only thing I need to do is just put a slight pip, and then I'm ready to go to the drill press. Well, I've got, this is the rod that I just got through threading. Hasn't been bent yet. Of course, this is the eccentric. Notice where it had the groove in it. Well, this is going to ride in the groove, but first it goes in here, screws in, then the eccentric goes over the hub like so, and that'll go in. Of course, you adjust it. I'll adjust it with that, and now that goes in there. Of course, it hasn't been lubed or anything, but that's got a good free ride in there. That turns very, very freely, and so I can complete that part. Now that goes on there, as you saw, and I had jumped the gun a little bit. I still need to make another couple of parts. This thing is coming to where it's not a whole lot more left to do on it, which is good because our house just went on sale this weekend. We've put our house up for sale so we can move back to Texas. I'll be retiring here in about another 60 days. So I've got a lot going on and with very little time in the shop. So I'm trying to get this engine finished before I do move. This is the exploded drawing. The parts that's been made over the last two videos are these parts right here. And this part number 31 here, the valve linkage, I'll have to make that, and that'll be on the next video. So I like doing that linkage. Let's see, I've got to build the packing nut steel, very, very easy to build that. And then I think it's mostly just some timing. We'll make some gaskets for it, and hopefully in about another two or three sessions, perhaps, this engine will be running. See you on the next video.